Good morning, everyone. Well, rained really hard last night and this morning. Got more rain on the way. But today's project is the final load of the RV. We're leaving tomorrow morning for Southeast Canada. So, I'm getting some lights on in here. Got a lot of stuff already loaded up. And by the way, did a little project instead of just having them piled up there. Got a lot of stuff already loaded, and now we're going to be loading the clothes and food and leave tomorrow. So come on along. So the way we do it is I grab laundry baskets, fill them up with clothes and food, and I carry them down to the RV or down to the barn and the RV and set them here. And then Angel hands me the empty ones, which I thought she was handing to me right now. Are you back there? There we go. And she'll hand me the one that I just carried down, and I'll go refill it. And now she gets to do this one. So we have finished with clothes in the bedroom. Now we've moved on to essential items for the kitchen and some food. Good morning, everyone. We are leaving today. We won't be home until September. We're doing our final packing. So let's get this thing all loaded up and pulled out of the barn. So we're finally on the road. It took us about 3 hours to get out this morning, but we've got the whole family, including Libby, and we're twisting along on the skinny, twisty roads, trying to get out of the Ozark Mountains. Away from the house to get to the nearest freeway, and we will be gone for about 4.5 months up to Southeast Canada, then out to the Pacific Coast, so about 10 to 12,000 miles. Let's enjoy this trip together.
Let's go.
First stop is Nashville to go to the Grand Ole Opry tomorrow night. This is at the campground. We get live music at the campground. Our first stop is Grand Ole Opry in Nashville. Ah, let's get Angel in there.
Yay!
We're going to the Opry tonight. And of course, we've already been in there spending money. All right. We made it to the inside of the Grand Ole Opry. We're up on the balcony, but this is the Grand Ole Opry. There she is.
She's happy.
And there's the stage down there. Believe it or not, it's closer than it really looks. Daily and Vincent.
I was gonna clear the air, but if I'm All right, one more stop before we cross into Canada. We're in the Detroit area still, and we decided to come on down to the Henry Ford Museum Greenfield Village, as long as we're here. Tomorrow we will be crossing into Canada and starting the trek to Southeast Canada. But meanwhile, we wanted to see the museum. It's been, probably 50 years since I've been here. 45, 50 years since I've been here when I was a kid, so. Brought Angel along. She's never been here.
I've never been here. I'm very excited.
So let's go check out the museum.
This is a Lincoln Continental that has the roof on. This is the exact car and that Kennedy was assassinated in back in Dallas. They, if I remember correctly, my history, he wanted the roof removed for his trip through Dallas, which was his downfall. This Lincoln Continental is the car that Reagan was shoved into when he got shot by Hinckley. ...1950 presidential Lincoln Continental. This one was used by Truman, Eisenhower, and Kennedy. Okay, another Lincoln Continental, or Lincoln anyhow, I don't know if it's a Continental. Unbelievable, that's when they used to make big cars. 1939, this one used by Roosevelt and Truman. All right, this one is not a Lincoln, but this is Teddy Roosevelt's. 1902. Used by Teddy Roosevelt. I cannot imagine driving one of these. Look at the size of this locomotive. Holy cow, this thing is huge. The wheels have got to be 5-6 feet tall. Unbelievably huge. Prototype of the first self-driving car. Absolutely amazing. 2016. And it's sitting next to a 1959 Cadillac Eldorado. What a beautiful car. Are you missing a Christmas ornament? Hallmark miniatures from 73 to 2009. There's supposed to be like 20,000 ornaments in here. George Washington's fold-up cot. I guess it folds up and sits in that trunk. How comfortable looking is that? This is the chair that Abraham Lincoln was sitting in the Ford Museum when he was assassinated. You can see stains on the chair. Never thought about where this chair was. Here's another unique item. Back in 59, Rosa Parks refused to get up and give her seat. And the actual bus is here in the museum that Rosa Parks was on that started the movement.
We
is Columbia.
We're inside the bus that Rosa Parks said no. And this is where she was sitting when the bus driver told her to get up and move, and she said no. She was subsequently arrested because the bus didn't move until they came and got her off.
Private citizen bought it for $500.
This is the whole bus.
And strip the...
The home of the future for 1946. All stainless steel and plexiglass.
Oh, not with that.
To the left.
A total of two of these were made in 46. The gentleman that designed them wasn't able to get funding. The two prototypes have been combined to make this one for the museum. Some really old tractors. Here's a four-row New Holland combine. Over here's steam-powered tractors. All kinds of old stuff. There's an Oscar Wienermobile over there. Here is a two-row combine that's pulled by a tractor and a PTO. No storage bin. Amazing what they have here. So we're at the KOA in Ann Arbor, and we're taking Libby out for a walk. I thought I'd give you all an update on poor little Libby. I don't know if I've mentioned it before, but I know I have out on Instagram and the Facebook page. But Libby is 5 years old, and she's recently been diagnosed with cancer. The vet doesn't even think we'll make it home from this trip, but we'll see what happens. We're hoping so. She's just enjoying the day, going out for a walk, sniffing around other people's campers. So... if you can, send some good wishes towards Libby.
So we're just finishing up the first leg of our trip this summer. We've been on the road for about a week. We're in Michigan, Ann Arbor Ypsilanti KOA. Been doing all kinds of stuff here, enjoying ourselves. This is the lake that's part of the KOA. That's KOA owns that lake that we hike around. Did all kinds of good stuff. The highlight for me was the Henry Ford Museum. The other highlight was spending time with family. As you know, I've got a bunch of family here in town, or in Michigan. But tomorrow morning, we head out and we head into Canada. So that'll be the starting of a new video. I'm going to try and break them up by the week as we do this trip. So hopefully you'll get a video every week or so. Anyhow, thanks for coming along. Hope this one wasn't too boring for you. Most of the time was spent with family, but... it was good to be here, but tomorrow we cross the Ambassador Bridge into Windsor, or we go up to Port Huron and cross the Blue Water Bridge. Haven't decided yet. Depends on traffic in the morning. So come on along for the rest of the trip, and hope you enjoyed this video. And if you haven't already, thanks for subscribing, and bye.